Welcome to St. John's UCC in Troy, Ohio, for our Christmas Eve service. We pray you all have a blessed Christmas time as we hope for a safe and healthy 2021. Let us now prepare to worship on this very holy night. Ginny now shares two favorite carols of Christmas time. O come, all ye faithful, and joy to the world.
Thank you. know what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all that they had heard and seen as it had been told them.
This past few weeks, the church as a whole, not just this one, but the church in general, has been celebrating a season called Advent. And Advent is all about waiting. And it is really important, I think, for us to learn the art of waiting and to learn to wait well. And we have surely learned something about that for the last 9 months or so. We've been waiting in quarantine. We have been waiting for this virus to pass. We've been waiting for a vaccine to be developed. We've been waiting for the world to get back to something that would be maybe a little bit more like normal, whatever that looks like. But something changes tonight that isn't the same as what we've been doing for these last 9 months. Tomorrow and tonight is not about waiting anymore. I'm not saying that we're done with the waiting. That wouldn't be realistic, and I doubt if it even would be healthy. But the theme of tonight is not waiting, because waiting is over. We're on the verge of something very new, something very different, and something life-changing about to happen. This is Christmas Eve. And in just a few hours, we will enter into Christmas Day, when suddenly the focus changes from sitting in the dark, looking at an empty crib, to the dawn of new life. A baby is born tonight, and there is new life among us. The sounds come from the crib, and they fill the space all around us when a baby is born. We all listen for those sounds. We're tuned to try to discover what every sound of the baby makes and what it means. The expressions on people's faces change when a baby comes into the room. It changes from the anguish of delivery pains to sheer joy. The attention has shifted, and we can't seem to keep our eyes off the new baby, that tiny, wiggling, breathing, hungry, eager life among us. It is as if the little light over the stable has given way to the breaking of a beautiful dawn in the birth of a baby. What changed? There is a presence among us that was not there just moments ago. And that presence has made all the difference. And I believe that's the truth. For followers of Jesus, it is not the presence at Christmas time. I mean the ones wrapped in good, nice paper and sparkling ribbons. It is about presence. His presence. His arrival. His life. From here on out, we cannot, we must not live in the darkness of fear and despair anymore. We are people who believe that in our very midst, a child has been born, a living, dynamic, love-infused presence of God is not just a dream, but tomorrow we think about that as the reality right here in our midst, in this moment, in this time. I can't begin to tell you what a difference it makes to have the birth of a baby in your home and in your family. And I don't mean
just imposes itself on everyone in the house. It isn't just mom who's been affected, although she has been affected in such an intimate and personal way, but so is dad affected, and the kids are affected, and even the dog is affected when the new baby comes into the house. Everyone's life changes forever on the day you bring the baby home. Living in the presence of new life changes everything. It always does. Whatever else you do in regard to the baby, you can't ignore it. And since that life is so tied to your life, you must guard it, and you must protect it, and you have to nurture it. You can know laughter, and you should, but that's not all. You can know tears, and you will. You can know joy, and that's as it should be, but what you can't do is ignore the new life. What is it like to actually welcome the living presence of the divine spirit of love and wholeness, the spirit of God, into our lives? You know what the angel said about this baby? You'll call his name Emmanuel, meaning God with us. The birth of Jesus, among other things, means that we are forever wrapped in divine love. What would it mean if we were to be keenly aware of the presence of God in our lives, like a mom lives, ever aware of a baby asleep in the other crib in the other room? How could you ever feel insignificant if the presence of God were alive and felt in your midst? How could you ever feel like your work is of no consequence with the presence of God in your home? It makes your moments more significant and your time count. This little life, this new baby Jesus, is God infused. In him is wisdom and power and compassion and hope. And forever, as he grows in us and as we grow as his followers, we need to let his life matter in our lives. His words are life-changing. His actions direct our own. And his compassion becomes the driving force of our life. Nothing is ever the same. As we hopefully welcome our first vaccine among us, signaling eventually the end to a long waiting, as we hopefully look toward the day when the pandemic doesn't invade our every waking moment, and as we move slowly but steadily away from the darkest day of the year, let's remind ourselves that Christ has been born and the beloved community is alive because he lives, and light is always more powerful than darkness. Today I want to wish you the most merry of Christmases, even in 2020. If you have a candle nearby, gather it and give a little shove to the darkness as Kirsta sings for you silently.